Coming to the most important topics of power electronics, that is rectifiers, inverters, choppers, AC voltage controllers and all. So the first topic is phase controlled rectifier. Listen, these are phase controlled, not normal rectifiers. In normal rectifiers you will use diodes, so these are controlled rectifiers. That means you have control on those devices. So those devices are SCRs here, are thyristors. So the first type is single phase half wave rectifier. So for this rectifier, the load can be of any type. It can be R, RL or RLE. So if the load is R load, then I am going to cover some important points only. So circuit turn off time is an important term. So as you all know, this should be greater than device turn off time. So what is this circuit turn off time? The time to which a reverse bias voltage is applied across the device, that is the thyristor. Because you can turn off a device only, means you can turn off SCR only when reverse bias voltage is applied across it. Okay, so that time is nothing but circuit turn off time. And if you observe the waveforms of these type with R load, omega TC will be pi, that is for 180 degrees of time reverse bias voltage will be applied. From that TC will be pi by omega. Okay, similarly beta is the extinction angle. Okay, that is also, that is pi, that is 180 degrees. Okay, and you need to determine the average voltage and RMS voltages of currents or output currents or output voltages. But how to determine that? So actually I am saying you here, I am not saying you the final formula, because it is important to know how to get that formula using integration. So here we will do the integration from alpha to pi, and the time period is 2 pi. Okay, and from pi to 2 pi it is 0 basically. That's why we are not considering. Generally the average voltage is V naught is equal to 1 by T integral 0 to T. So out of that 0 to T, that is 2 pi here, we are going to consider the duration during which that is non-zero. That means V naught, in V naught waveform it is non-zero from alpha to pi. That's why we are considering from alpha to pi. And the waveform, what is that? That is Vm sin omega t, right? That's why we are considering it. Fine. Similarly, you can find out V naught RMS. You all know how to find out that. Then as it is R load, this I naught average will be V naught average by capital R. That's it. And one more important point is, that is power factor. So we all know the definition for power factor is power delivered to load divided by source VA. Remember, that is source VA, that means volt amperes, kilowatts by VA is nothing but power factor, right? Active power by apparent power, that's what here it is again. So the power delivered to load will be V naught RMS square divided by R, and source VA is source voltage RMS into source current RMS. Then if you do simplification, you will get V naught R by Vs, where V naught R is output RMS voltage and Vs is source RMS voltage. Fine, right?